Hey there, Star Wars fans, another Fly Guy doing a figure review. Got an older figure here, going back towards all this Jabba's Palace stuff I've been buying over recent reviews. So that's the Rancor, some of the Weequee Skiff Guards, a Man-A-Man, and a lot more stuff that was kind of rounding out this Jabba's Palace. In fact, you can see some of the scene behind me where the Rancor is. So one of these figures that a good friend managed to pick me up is a figure called Ephantmon. And if you blink, you'll... not see him in Return of the Jedi, which is where he appears, and he only really appears for a couple of minutes. Just before I show you the figure, just to give you a look at what's left of the packaging, because I did buy this opened, but the item was brand new still in its packaging. It's a massive piece of plastic. Now, if that doesn't look like much, if I show you a standard vintage card, and you can maybe see the difference if I compare the two together. This is one big ass piece of a figure. It's huge, absolutely massive. You could kill somebody with this thing, it's so heavy. So a really large figure casing that it comes in, so no wonder Hasbro didn't release too many of these. But what's available of the package is here, and it's a Power of the Force, or Power of the Jedi line, I think it was, that this appeared in. So there's just a brief shot of the card. Let me in fact take that out there. Return of the Jedi, Ephantmon. As you can see, he's a very attractive looking guy. Kind of resembling something from Easter Island, with this long, long face, and as Jabba's head of security, as it states there. So, having just watched a bit of Return of the Jedi the other day, you do get to see this guy a couple of times now. I always thought he was just barely in the movie, but he is there literally for a couple of seconds on in two or three shots. But let's get a look at that figure. So, what do you get for your plastic? Well, you get a big, big figure, let me tell you. This guy is absolutely massive. He's even heavy to hold, so let me give you a quick 360 of him as he takes up the entire screen. And as you can see, as I said, an attractive looking beast he is indeed. Ladies, be careful, this guy is married, I think. Such a beautiful figure by Hasbro. Just as I quickly go around, you'll see even the detail for an older figure that, again, has very limited... need to have articulation. It actually does come with a fair bit of it, and it's had some real planning and forethought by Hasbro is what they've done here. So as you can see, he's got a tail at the back, this large cloak, and this head. And now he also comes with one, I believe it's made of a spine or part of a spine or bones of some kind. There's some mention of that on Wikipedia if you want to have a look up there. You can see the detail on this. Let me just give you a better look at this. Oops, these heavies falling all over the place. So you can see the intricate detail that Hasbro have done. There's actually that Jabba's clan emblem on there. We talked about this on the Jabba's Throne review, and people commented this insignia, this almost double anchor you can see on there is part of that emblem they have, I think, or Jabba or the Hutts have. So again, detail like that, which you wouldn't really expect, but it's on there. So there's the Hasbro guys and girls who develop this stuff and design and make these molds are amazingly talented people. To spend all that time to do these is really a work of art. So a beautiful piece, and that's his staff, which goes in his hand. But again, back to the figure. God, he really is ugly. One key thing you obviously notice there is this huge mouth, which is articulated. So we get an articulated jaw, and he gets this decent kind of movement. And again, paint is applied beautifully. The teeth are yellowed and gnarly, just as the stock photography is of the movie. In terms of one other attachment he has, buried beneath his cloak, and you do have to kind of add it on there, is this rather cool looking knife come blade, vibro blade thing. And let me just take that off, because again, another cool piece is it has a little nodule that you can clip onto his belt. Fantastic, again, for an older figure, this is just amazing. The detail again on this, I don't know, vibro knife thing he has is pretty intense. You've got the leather kind of wrapped handle that's been done, and obviously all the steel buttons and the blade itself and the silver. It looks just fantastic. And again, that peg allows that to fit onto his kind of utility belt that he has around there. I'm making him sound like Batman, but there you go. Here's Efont Mons underwear, ladies. You can get a good look at the his jock strap that he's got on there. And he comes with his little suspender by his side. And this is just wrong. It's his little pouches he's got there. Not that pouch, the other kind of ammunition pouch he's got. And again, that peg holder there to clip on that vibro blade or whatever you want to call it. Let me just put that back on. It really fits in well. In fact, I won't, because I'll show you the articulation first. And this, again, for an older figure, remember, this is Power of the Jedi. This is pre-Phantom Menace stuff. This guy has amazing articulation. For a big lump of plastic, full articulated arms. Obviously, there's no more real articulation in that. In there, but still getting that is pretty amazing. I didn't expect much at all. So not only the arms are articulated, hands up for Efont Mon, but you can then also, his entire jaw turns upside down, and there you go. There's a good look at Efont Mon's little belly, and again his little jock strap thing, which I'm really not comfortable seeing all the time. So there you go. It's pretty good for that. And even if we flip round and have a look, there's detail at the back of this. Now, I would have expected Hasbro to cheap out a little bit. I would have. And just kind of had that as a very simple, clean plastic background. Because, again, this is the back of this guy's head. You're not really going to be seeing it. But, no, they really added all the detail. Efont Mon's little belly and all his bits and pieces. And added all that kind of detail to you. And as you'll see, the plastic kind of cape draped around. It's glued on pretty firmly there along his head, but adds a really nice effect and depth round there to make that look real and not just kind of molded on there. So beautifully done piece of work. He's a huge ugly dude, but again, the point is that Hasbro spent so much love on this. Very similar to one of the other figures we reviewed recently, and a lot of other people loved them too, which was Hermie Odal, another great figure you'll find. We've got it reviewed in the channel if you want to dig that out. Another huge Jabba's denizen, and one that's really worth picking up. So not only is that articulation for that head there as well, but we also get articulated legs, which is just phenomenal. And you get to see his blue kind of tail there. The plastic on the cape is very stiff at the back, so you can't move that. There is some slight movement with this tail. It actually has some rotation. If I'm able to get it away from its cape, you'd actually see that it's a fully rotating tail. But the cape's designed a little bit to have that to pop out just at the back, just the underneath that kind of circular piece where my finger is. So that's how that's designed. But again, beautifully done. All that detail, all the detail at the back of his legs, on his hoofs, the paintwork. This is a stunning figure, and if you've never picked it up, I urge you to go out and try and get this online. Good friend managed to pick this, two of them up, brand new in the packets, and we got them shipped for round about $18 US, $18 Australian each, which is an absolute bargain for a huge weighty lump of plastic like this. So a pretty stunning figure. One which many like me have never really seen before. I never really collected much of the what we call the dark times on the podcast that we run, because there really wasn't a great deal of figures that I thought. I never really loved all the Power of the Force, the very chesty looking large figures, but these guys are very, very cool indeed. I think there's actually, yep, and that's right, there's articulation in the hands too. So these incredibly, get a look at those gnarly, really screwed up looking hands that he's got on there. Absolutely amazing detail that Hasbro have done. The guy or girl who made this really spent so much love on this. It is absolutely phenomenal. So again, give yourself a big smiley for knowing you're a very amazing figure. So I think you can tell I really like this one, and it's one I think you should pick up. But let me know what you think. Did you guys ever pick this up? Love to hear from you. Your thoughts as usual. Can you find it online? Can you see it still in some stores? Ever seen these lying around somewhere cheaply as maybe discounted or at a bargain sale or some kind of place you've ever seen them? Let us know. Love to hear your thoughts. Comments below, or as usual on facebook.com, flyguy.net. And we'll see you for another figure review real soon. Cheers.